Go.
Stop clapping.
I'm Tay Piss, and you're watching the Tay Piss Movie Exploratory. As you all know, I love watching rom-coms with my uncle. My favorite rom-com to watch of all time is 10 Things I Hate About You, starring Heath Ledger and that other guy. It's such a good movie. I just love it every time I watch it. I love it even more every time I watch it. Now, that movie is a romantic comedy, and as you know, rom-com is my favorite genre of movies. There's just so much about it that I love.
It's too much.
The rom-com is a versatile genre. It is a portmanteau of the words romantic and comedy. These two words are a major contributor into the genre's quirky characteristics. The first rom-com began with the Shakespearean play Merchant in Venice. And now, in the 1950s and 60s, it was very popular. It had a revival in the 1990s and the early to mid-2000s. And now it's on Netflix, with an increase in inclusivity, with race and homosexuality, too.
That's good. We got it. Here are some conventions of rom-coms. This is the beginning of a rom-com film where the two meet in this really awkward circumstance, this funny, awkward, weird circumstance that sets up the relationship. Another convention would be the two main characters. Bailing out my brain, red light flash. In the rom-com, there are usually two main characters, being the male lead and the female lead. Each of these characters is initially at odds with each other. They clash against each other and they don't mesh. But as the film progresses, they find out, like, they love each other secretly on the inside. I'm still alive, up in smoke, moon is low. As you know, didn't say I did. This is this, you know what this is. But do you know? Yeah. Until you reach the sort of climax area where they like break up, you know, one person accidentally cheats on the other person or something. Or the lie, the ruse that set it all up is revealed. And that is sort of like the climax. So what comes next? Right away. And then they get back together.
Each of the characters have same-sex partners that cheer them on and provide comic relief. The romantic comedy usually ends with a happy ending, reaffirming the love that the characters share for one another.
The romantic comedy has the main audience of what we deciphered to be couples, okay? The comedy element usually does appeal to a sort of masculine audience, and it's sort of like a little carrot on the stick for the girlfriend that's bringing these their male partners into the cinema, you know? The characters of a rom-com, they usually are in that sort of age bracket of like a serious dating couple, you know, like in the late 20s, 30s, sort of like romance time period. Got blood rushed in my head, they hot lock popping off the fucking black, not clocking wristed, watch been top off. Rom-coms, they end with true love, you know, they fall in love in the end. And that's something that you want from, that the audience wants. Advancements in technology have aided the production of rom-coms. They're now shot on digital cameras against green screens, which can sort of reduce budget that's spent on environmental. So, just over time passing, inclusivity has become like very big in the genre. Like gay people, race people, they all show up in these rom-com genres these days, and that's good to see as a society standpoint. Another thing. Keep going.